Good morning, everyone. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss about pumping lemma for regular sets. So what is pumping lemma? How you can prove that whether a set is not regular by using pumping lemma will be discussed in this lecture. So pumping lemma is actually used to prove that given set is not a regular set. It is actually a proof by contradiction. That means we are taking an assumption, a contradictory assumption as a truth in first hand, and then we perform some task, and after performing some task at the end, if we find that assumption as not meeting what we have assumed, that means we whatever assumption we have taken was contradictory. So in this way, we will prove that whatever set we have got is regular or not regular. So one more thing I would like to mention over here, that if you want to prove that a particular set is a regular set, then what you will have to do, you will have to make a finite state machine for it. Okay. And if you want to prove that a particular set, given set, is not a regular set, then you have to apply the pumping lemma for it. Okay, because if you are not able to make a finite state machine, that doesn't mean that that the given set is not regular. Maybe you are not able to make the finite state machine for that given set, language set. So pumping lemma will be applied whenever we have to prove that given set is not a regular set. Okay, so how to do it? So for applying the pumping lemma to a set, we have to make an assumption that given set is regular. First of all, we have to make contradictory assumption first of all. So we'll assume that given set L is regular. Now we will consider an arbitrary string from L, any string from L, and we'll name it as Z. Okay. Now Z is divided into three parts, U, V, and W, substrings of Z, such that mod of UV, that is length of UV, should be less than or equals to N, and length of V should be greater than or equals to 1. Means we cannot take length of V as 0. Okay. It should be something. It should be at least one alphabet. So after dividing it into three parts, that is U, V, and W, what we will do? We will find out some V in the expression such that this expression holds, or this expression founds to be true. That is U V raised to the power I W belongs to L for all I that is greater than or equals to 0. If this expression holds true for every value of I, we will say that the set is regular. And if for any case, this expression will be proven as false, then we will say that the set is not a regular set. Okay. So let us understand it by taking an example. So at last, we will say that if no such V exists, that means there is no machine which can accept such given language set. And that is a contradiction to step one. Therefore, we can declare that the set is L is not a regular set. So let us understand it by taking an example. So I have taken in language set 0 to the power N, 1 to the power N, where N is greater than or equals to 1. And I have to prove that it is not a regular set. So how I will prove it? So first of all, I will find out what type of strings are there in this set. So 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, and so on. That means the same number of zeros followed by the same number of ones will come in this type of language. Now I will consider any one string out of this language set as, and will name it as Z. So I've taken 0, 0, 1 here. Any arbitrary string, you can take any case over here. So I have taken 0000111 over here and name it as Z. Now in the next step, I have to divide it into three parts, that is U, V, and W. So let us take a few cases. So for in case one, what I have done, these division of U, V, and W will vary from person to person. Now that is why I am taking different cases. So for in first case, what I have done, I have taken U as 00, V as 01, and W as 11. So I've divided this Z into equal parts of two lengths. Okay. Now what I'll do for I is equals to 0, I will check this expression U V raised to the power I W belongs to L. So for I is equals to 0, as I substituted the values of U, V, and W, what happened? That I got 00011, and yes, it belongs to L, so good. Now I will move towards U, I is equals to 1. I will check the value for I is equals to 1. So when I place the value of U, V and W and check for I is equals to 1, yes, it is satisfying the expression U, V raised to the power I, W belongs to L. Now I checked it for I is equals to 2. And as I placed it in I is equals to 2 expression, what is happening over here? That in the middle portion, 0101 is appearing twice, and there is no such string appearing in this language set L. So it does not. So since it is not belonging to L, we'll say that case for case one, it doesn't satisfy. Okay. So what is to be done next? We'll take case two. Another case might be there might be some other case where this UV raised to the power I W belongs to L must be satisfying. So I have taken U as single 0, V as 00 and W as 111. Now I checked it for I is equals to 0. So as I place the value of U, V and W, what is happening? It becomes 0111 and it does not belongs to L, because in my language set, number of zeros was equals to number of 1. So it does not belongs to L. So case 2 is also not satisfying for it. So what I'll do, I will take case some case 3 also. So in case 3, what I have done, I have taken U as 000, V as single 1 and W as 11. So I've checked it for, again, for I is equals to 0. So what is happening? 00011 came and it is also not belonging to L. So I'll say that case 3 is also not satisfying. So in this way, you can say after taking few cases, 3 or 4 cases, if it is not satisfying for all possible combinations, so what you can say, you can directly say that the assumption taken in the first step that L is regular is contradictory, and therefore we can say that L is not a regular set. So this is how you can prove that a given set as not regular by using pumping lemma. Thank you so much.